Cleopatra VII Philopater 69 BC to 30 BC was the last active ruler of the Ptolemaic Kingdom of Egypt, a member of the Ptolemaic dynasty. She was a descendant of its founder Ptolemy I Soter, a Macedonian Greek general and companion of Alexander the Great. Cleopatra VII ruled ancient Egypt as co-regent, first with her father, then with her two younger brothers, and finally with her son. For almost three decades, she was part of a dynasty of Macedonian rulers. Cleopatra could speak various languages and served as the dominant ruler in all three of her co-regencies. Her romantic liaisons and military alliances with the Roman leaders Julius Caesar and Mark Antony, as well as her supposed exotic beauty and powers of seduction, earned her an enduring place in history and popular myth. Cleopatra was a daughter of Ptolemy XII, Orletes, a descendant of Ptolemy I Soter, one of Alexander the Great's generals and the founder of the Ptolemaic line in Egypt. Her mother was believed to be Cleopatra V Tryphena, the king's wife, and possibly his half-sister. In 51 BC, upon the apparently natural death of Orletes, the Egyptian throne passed to 18-year-old Cleopatra and her 10-year-old brother, Ptolemy XIII. Soon after the siblings' ascension to the throne, Ptolemy's advisers acted against Cleopatra, who was forced to flee Egypt for Syria in 49 BC. She raised an army of mercenaries and returned the following year to face her brother's forces in a civil war at Pelusium, on Egypt's eastern border. Meanwhile, after allowing the Roman general Pompey to be murdered, Ptolemy XIII welcomed the arrival of Pompey's rival, Julius Caesar, to Alexandria. In order to help her cause, Cleopatra sought Caesar's support, reportedly smuggling herself into the royal palace to plead her case with him. For his part, Caesar needed to fund his own return to power in Rome, and needed Egypt to repay the debts incurred by Orletes. After 4 months of war between Caesar's outnumbered forces and those of Ptolemy XIII, Roman reinforcements arrived. Ptolemy was forced to flee Alexandria, and was believed to have drowned in the Nile River. Entering Alexandria as an unpopular conqueror, Caesar restored the throne to the equally unpopular Cleopatra and her younger brother Ptolemy XIV, then 13 years old. Caesar remained in Egypt with Cleopatra for a time, and around 47 BC she gave birth to a son, Ptolemy Caesar. He was believed to be Caesar's child, and was known by the Egyptian people as Caesarion, or Little Caesar. Sometime in 46-45 BC, Cleopatra traveled with Ptolemy XIV and Caesarion to Rome to visit Caesar, who had returned earlier. After Caesar was murdered in March 44 BC, Cleopatra went back to Egypt. Ptolemy XIV was killed soon after, possibly by Cleopatra's agents, and the three-year-old Caesarion was named co-regent with his mother, as Ptolemy XV. By this point, Cleopatra had strongly identified herself with the goddess Isis, the sister wife of Osiris and mother of Horus, This was consistent with the ancient Egyptian tradition of associating royalty with divinity in order to reinforce the position of kings and queens. Cleopatra III had also claimed to be associated with Isis, and Cleopatra VII was referred to as the New Isis. She spoke as many as a dozen languages and was renowned for her irresistible charm. With her infant son as co-regent, Cleopatra's hold on power in Egypt was more secure than it had ever been. Still, unreliable flooding of the Nile resulted in failing crops, leading to inflation and hunger. Meanwhile, a conflict was raging in Rome between a second triumvirate of Caesar's allies, Mark Antony, Octavian and Lepidus, and his assassins, Brutus and Cassius. Both sides asked for Egyptian support, and after some stalling, Cleopatra sent four Roman legions stationed in Egypt by Caesar to support the triumvirate. In 42 BC, after defeating the forces of Brutus and Cassius in the battles of Philippi, Mark Antony and Octavian divided power in Rome. Mark Antony soon summoned Cleopatra to the Sicilian city of Tarsus, south of modern Turkey, to explain the role she had played in the complicated aftermath of Caesar's assassination. According to the story recorded by Plutarch, and later dramatized famously by William Shakespeare, Cleopatra sailed to Tarsus in an elaborate ship, dressed in the robes of Isis. Antony, who associated himself with the Greek deity Dionysus, was seduced by her charms.